Hello and welcome back to another Reality Check VR video. Today we're going to be jumping into Dispatch. This is an episodic story told in four parts. It's kind of like a little visual VR journey where you get to jump into the eyes and ears of a dispatch, somebody, you know, police officer. And it's a very interesting, dramatic story. So I wanted to make this video. If you've paid attention to the channel before, I did live stream this game or this experience back when it came out several weeks ago, but I never made that video public. I kept it unlisted because of the sensitive material. And it took me a while of thinking, you know, whether or not I should actually make this video public or whether or not I should do a video on this. And I was kind of torn whether or not I should, because it is very sensitive material. If you or your loved ones or somebody close to you have ever been involved in domestic abuse or domestic violence, it's certainly something that can evoke a lot of emotions, a lot of things, a lot of pain. So because of those things, it's something that not everybody's going to want to experience. Not everybody is going to want to watch this. But for people out there that want to learn, for people out there who haven't experienced those things, who want to, you know, obviously be sure that they don't experience those things, also have a heart for those people who have, this experience is very eye-opening. It's a very good learning experience. And as far as the art, it's a very, very amazing art piece, because the way that they've actually brought in visual effects with audio is just stunning. So without talking anymore, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the camera, and I'm just going to go ahead and play through. I believe we have the first three parts available. The fourth part will be coming out later. So I'm going to jump into it right now, and I hope you guys enjoy it. I'll see you at the end of the video.
"911, what is your location?"
"Help! Help me! Help me!"
"Okay, I can help you, but I need you to speak clearly and tell me where you are."
"I don't know! I'm in the woods! It's dark!"
"You're in the woods. Which woods? I need a specific location."
"I can't see anything, man! Oh, everyone's gone! All right, I'm the only one left!"
"Who is everyone? Where are you? I need to know which woods you're in so that I can help you."
"I don't know! I don't know where I am, okay?" I can hear it."
"What is it?"
"Oh God, I can hear it."
"Is someone chasing you? What is it?"
"It's behind me."
"Hear it. What is it?"
"It's behind me. I don't want to die, man.
What is behind you? I want to help you. I just can't if you don't tell me specifically where you are."
"It's coming for me, okay? You gotta help me, man. It's coming for me.
"What is coming for you?"
It's your mom."
101. "Some assholes in a basement wasting my time. Wake up their parents, please."
10-4.
"Do you have an emergency to declare?"
"Yeah. Oh, God. Sorry. I totally do. A 911 operator just shit his pants."
"Someone could be dying right now as you waste my fucking time."
"Yeah, no. Someone totally is dying, and it's me. I'm dying of laughter because..."
"That would be a better outcome to this phone call if you were dead." "Don't call here again."
"You can't talk to me like that, okay? My dad's a CPA. I will report you."
"Report me." "Sheriff, I appreciate that you gave me a second chance. But this isn't what I thought it would be. I'm having trouble adjusting to this life.
I hate this fucking job.
Dealing with these calls has been more than I can handle.
I've never felt less appreciated in my entire life.
I'm not the guy for this job.
I can't handle the stress, their lives.
I know that now.
Their needs, they could give a shit about me.
I appreciate how you helped me.
Thank you for pitying me enough to put me behind this fucking desk.
But this isn't helping me." "911, what is your location?"
"I'd like to order a pizza."
"Ma'am, this isn't funny. This line is for emergencies. I can have you charged with a misdemeanor for wasting police resources and my time." "Are you in danger?"
"Yes."
"Is there
someone there with you? Is there someone that's going to hurt
this
you?
This part gives me the chills.
Can I get the pizza delivered to my house?
What is your address?
1459 Cotta Lane.
Okay, police are on their way. Hold on 1 minute.
Hurry, I think you know.
Calling all available deputies.
This is 103.
Ray, we got a domestic. Sounds pretty bad. Address is 1459 Cotta Lane. Run emergent.
Hello, can you hear me?
Oh, God. Please, 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 please. He's coming after me.
Okay, where are you now?
In the bathroom.
Okay. Is the door closed? Did you lock it?
Yes.
Okay, police are on their way right now. Stay calm. Is there anything you can do to defend yourself with?
He's breaking down the door. He's gonna kill me.
We are on our way. What is your name?
Nicole Marie.
Nicole Marie. My name is Tim. I'm going to be here with you until the officers arrive.
Nicole, don't tell me his name.
Can you hear me?
His name. Tell me.
Sheriff.
En route. What's the situation? Give me a report. I'm about to walk into a crime scene.
10-16 turned into a 35. Husband sounded like he was beating her up pretty bad, and then
the line went dead.
Look, listening to a person, I know it can be tough, but I need you to act like a professional.
Oh, what is that supposed to mean?
I just got a complaint, that's what it means. Did you curse out a couple of teenagers earlier?
No. Why, they prank called. I might have said
you
a few things.
You might have said some things, you might have said some
they
things.
They had me going. They were calling the station. Why are we even talking about this? Who gives
we're
a shit if I curse
We're talking about it because
them?
I give a shit. When someone files a complaint against one of my dispatchers, it's on me. Again.
It's my fault now?
Yes.
Again?
You've got an attitude problem, Ted. You do. Like it or not, you do. I've been patient with you more than I have with most.
Yeah. Well, what makes me so special?
Quit arguing with me. And quit arguing with callers. That's not your job. Your job is to help people.
I need to talk to you about my job and things aren't panning out the way that... I need to sit down and talk to you.
Well, it's gotta wait. I gotta get inside.
My nose.
911, what's your location?
Hey, hello? This the police?
Yes. Tell me your location, please.
Yeah, this guy is on his way to my house and he's looking for a fight. You better send somebody.
Okay, I can help you, but I need to know where you are.
I'm gonna fuck him up. I'm just calling you guys so I don't get arrested.
Okay, I need to know where you are, sir. What's your location?
Inside my house.
All right, do me a favor. Lock your doors and windows. Don't go outside, okay? Who's this guy? Describe him for me. Tall, short, black, white.
He's white. He's tall. He's a big guy.
How do you know him? What's his name?
Yeah, I know him. His name's Franklin.
How do you know him?
I know his wife.
How do you know his wife?
We went to high school together. What's with these questions, man? Just send somebody.
What is your address?
2418 West Ohio Street.
Deputy 103, Ray.
Dispatch, we got a 187. Vic is a Nicole Marie Fowler, female Caucasian. Ted, you copy?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm here.
Perp fled, male Caucasian, probably husband, Franklin Fowler.
I'm on the line with a guy right now, says Franklin is on his way to his house. Says there's going to be a fight. I think it's the same guy.
Give me the address.
2418 West Ohio Street.
10-4.
Sir, I've got an officer heading your way. Hello? Sir?
Whoa. There's a truck out front. It wasn't there a minute ago. Someone's getting out. It's a man. Shh. It's Franklin.
Okay. Stay inside. Police are on their way.
If he steps on my lawn, I'm putting him on the fucking ground.
Listen to me. This man is extremely dangerous. We're after him already. You just need to stay inside and stay safe.
No, he thinks he can show up at my house? No fucking way.
Sir, he's dangerous. I mean it. He'll kill you too.
What'd you say?
Sir, lock your door and stay inside. I mean it.
Did something happen to Nicole? Did he hurt her?
I can't disclose that information.
You tell me what happened to Nicole. I want to know if something happened to her.
You just have to make sure you stay inside and he stays outside.
And Jesus Christ, I told her to leave him. I knew he'd hurt her.
Now's not the time for that. You need to stay safe, okay? You take my word for it. Stay inside.
I can hear him out front. He's walking up the steps, man.
Towards the front door?
Yes, he's right by the front door.
Is it locked?
Yes, it's locked, but I'm trying to get in. See, he's going over to the window.
Is the window locked?
Yes, the window is locked, man. Yes.
Everything is locked.
Yes, he's at the other window right now, man. Yes, everything is locked. Everything's locked.
Okay. I need you to tell me everything that's happening.
He's going around back. Oh my God. Dude, what am I gonna do, man?
Do you have anything you can use to protect yourself?
Yeah, there's a knife on the kitchen table.
Okay, get the knife.
Okay.
You have the knife?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
Oh, shit. He's not gonna get inside, man, is he? Is he gonna get in?
Not if you lock that door.
Yes, all right. He's at the back door, man. He's trying to get in.
He's not gonna get in. You protect yourself with that knife if you have to.
Dude, he's trying to break the damn door down, man. Oh, shit.
What is it? Did he get in?
No. My wife just got home.
Your wife?
Shit, man, you better bring send somebody quick, man.
They're on their way. You have to get to her before he does.
Yes.
Go get your wife.
Hey, baby, what's...
No!
Did Nicole tell you I was coming?
Get your hands... Come here!
Hey, shut up! Did you love her?
Trevor? Can you hear me?
Do you love her?
Trevor, officers are on their way. Hello?
Oh, yeah? Hey, hello? Huh? You hearing this? It's too late, buddy. You can't save them.
All units, perp on the scene. Repeat, Franklin Fowler on scene. I've lost the call. Status?
I'm 8 minutes out.
Sheriff. Status?
10 minutes out.
Give me your 20s. I can find faster routes.
Dispatch, we got this covered. Just stay with the caller until we get there.
I can help. He's in there right
stay
now.
Stay with the caller, Ted.
I'm not going to listen to another person die because you can't get there in
Listening's
time.
Listening's your job, goddammit.
Well, now it's yours.
Oh my God. Turn it off! Ted, cut me off!
Deputies, update. Sheriff, update. Sheriff?
187. One down. Male. African American. Fowler's gone. Put out a bolo. Call Beller County PD. Next door. We need roadblocks on all highways.
There was a woman.
Trevor's wife. I think her name was Gloria. She pulled her car into the driveway. Is it there?
There's no car in the driveway. Wait, we've got a blood trail.
Great work, detective. She's in her car, out there somewhere. Go find her.
This is nobody's fault, Ted. I got deputies working hard out
here.
Well,
all you do is pick up the pieces. I'm the one that has to listen to this shit.
Hey, I don't tolerate talk like
that. I don't give a shit. What do you tolerate? When there's a person dying in my ear. If I was out there...
You're not out here. You're not out here, Ted. You can't do this job. That's a hard fact, and I get it.
No.
But don't take it out
you
on
don't.
Me.
Get it. I can do anything you can do. You hearing me? Anything. You know what? I don't need this shit. Fuck this. I quit. Okay, my systems. I have you. I can see where you are now. You're not too far from the precinct. Okay, look. You're gonna come to me, okay? I'm gonna direct you to where I am. Okay, you're gonna go straight for 3/4 of a mile, and you're gonna make a right on Falconer Street. The precinct is another mile on Falconer.
Okay.
Stay calm. You will be here in 5 minutes. Okay?
Dad, I have blood on me. Oh my God. I'm covered in Trevor's blood.
Gloria, listen to me. Stay with me now, okay? You can do this.
He stabbed my husband.
I understand.
He killed him. And
I understand.
He was smiling. Why?
I don't know why. No one knows why. He hurt someone. Now he's trying to blame everyone but himself. But we
Nicole.
Need to stay focused.
He kept saying her name. Nicole. I don't know who that is. Trevor, did
Gloria,
he do something?
I don't know, but we have to stay focused. We can figure that out later, okay? Are you holding on to the wheel?
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
Hold on to it tight, okay?
My hands are shaking. I'm shaking all
That's
over.
That's okay. Just hold on to that wheel. Focus on your breathing. Breathe.
What's your name?
Ted.
Okay.
Ted. Okay?
Ted.
Yes.
Thanks, Ted.
For what?
For talking to me.
Yeah.
There's someone behind me. He's going really fast.
Okay. It might be an officer, so...
No. It's not. It's a truck. Shit! I think it's him. What do I do? What do I do?
How far back is he?
I don't know. He's coming quick.
Okay. You're coming up on Falconer, so you're going to make a right.
Okay?
You're going to make this right, and you're going to pull over and park as quickly as you can to turn off all your lights, okay?
Yes.
Can you do that?
Okay, here I go.
Okay. Turn off your lights. Turn off your car. Is it off?
Yes.
Okay. Duck down.
Okay.
Duck down as low as you can. So I can't see you. He's past you?
No, he stopped.
He stopped when he's past you.
He's reversing.
Okay.
He's coming back.
Gloria, you have to turn your car back on right now and step on it.
No, but he's...
Gloria, you don't have a choice. Drive.
He's chasing me
Watch
again.
It. It's a straight shot down Falconer, just half a mile. Okay? You can make it.
There's a train crossing up ahead. The crossing bars are already coming down.
Is it a commuter or a freight? How long is the train?
It's long.
Short or long?
No, it's long. Really,
good.
Very long.
Good. The call center is on the other side of those tracks. Do you think you can beat it?
I have to, right?
Yes. You have to.
Something.
And that, folks, is Dispatch. It, it is a very interesting VR, experience that I think is a must try if it's something that you believe could be interesting for you. Definitely the way that it goes from looking at like a 2D screen and then all of a sudden you're enveloped in an entire 3D environment. The way that it puts you from, you know, screen to from situation to situation, the way they make things look small and then all of a sudden those small things become huge on the screen. all just very amazing aspects, which, you know, if you have this, you need to definitely check it out. The first episode is free. The other two, I believe I paid $2.99 to get those. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to go ahead and end it right now, and I'll see you guys back next time with some more cheerful VR content. Thanks for watching. Bye.